side, since in ninjutsu and kyujutsu, it's important to be able to use both hands in case one is injured in a way that the bow is difficult to hold, and then you can switch hands and use the other side. Or simply, even for certain areas of shooting, they require a left-handed draw. So I'm going to cover that right now and kind of show it from using the ibira here with the arrows. So it's held in the back this way, but it can also be in the front when I'm moving through like narrow trails or areas, corridors, so that they don't get caught on anything and they're in front of me this way, or behind me this way. Here. Put the bow down here. So as I'm moving through, I'm drawing from behind. I can mount the arrow in front without them seeing this way as I'm watching my target start moving out. But for switching sides, I'm going from here, and okay, then when we switch sides, we bring the bow to here, and just turn this around to here, to front, and then reach inside here. So I'm reaching inside and just turning it around behind me. So now then I aim at the target from here, and I'm drawing from underneath about a hand width from here. Drawing from underneath, and as I draw, I'm looking around at any other approaching targets. So that's the moment that I'm looking around, is when I reach back and draw again, because I want to make sure after I shoot, more animals or enemies aren't coming in at me. So as I draw, I'm looking around this way. I'm placing it between the fingers here because of the left side Hidarigawa. I'm placing it here in between the fingers at an angle, so that by time I slide it in this way, it's basically, it's already fallen into place. Here. Okay, so in practicing this, what you want to do is, like, if you have like 10 arrows, and then practice 5 to one side, and then 5 to the other side by just switching it back. So when I go back to here, I bring the bow up, I bring it around to here, and I'm back to here. I draw out, and as I do, I'm looking back at for any possible animals. I'm bringing the arrow up. The tip lands up just slightly in front of the finger. Here. It doesn't go here. It places, when I place it, I'm placing it right here, and then I'm just pressing in with the finger, and I'm sliding the hand slightly back. I want to keep the elbow up from this point here, and I'm looking at my target. I'm not looking down. I'm not looking here or here. I'm looking at my target. So I'm doing this without looking, and I'm feeling the arrows, the feathers here with my fingertips. So as I slide it in here, point your finger at the target. Keep your elbow up. It's not down here. It's not up here. It's not like this. It's like this. Here. Knees are back. I'm not looking. I'm looking at the target. Once I get to here, I'm slightly turning it, and as I'm pulling, just before I'm pulling back, I'm popping it, I'm knocking it. So, as I'm going here, so it's really, from here, I'm feeling this should line up to where I know my knock is pointed up. So when I feel here, I can just go straight in, and it's there. And I don't have to sight it. Here, see, I'm feeling it. I know it's there, and it's in. And I just, if it's not, I just slightly turn it, and it knocks itself. As soon as I place it here, okay? Because now that, if you're trying to do the speed shooting, then you don't want to be sitting here and trying to look to see where it's at. You don't have time for that. And placing it here, this isn't Kyudo, okay? Kyudo is very meditative. It's slow, like this, okay? It's not like that. This is, you know, combative hunting, archery. So it's meant for evasive type shooting, hiding, concealing, moving, rolling, and you gotta know where to move the arrows on the body when you maneuver so that they're not in your way. And if you're having to suddenly move into a concealed location, how they're not sticking up in the air, giving away your position. So again, once you do your five on one side, okay, then switch it to here, okay? Then bring it around the waist to here, and then reach under and pull it around back, aim back at the target, look back, I'm looking around, I bring the arrow up, and it falls right into place here, okay? So I want to have my hand slightly angled up when I first position it here, and then sliding it in, my bow is slightly at an angle, okay? And I'm, see, I'm twisting it. As soon as I mount it, I'm twisting it. You want to get to where this feather is facing out. That one single feather faces away from the bow. Okay, otherwise when you shoot, it's going to, if I have that one facing in, then when it shoots, it's gonna cause it to turn like this. So I want those two facing in that way. Okay, and I want to practice shooting enough to where my left side feels totally natural, and I don't feel awkward shooting from my left side.